Hey Vibe, thank you for joining me on 31 Days of Fitness. I hope you guys are going strong. My name is Raquel Harris, founder of The Champion Experience. The Champion Experience was created to inspire others to explore their strength, power, and athletic abilities through training. Our program applies techniques from both boxing and Muay Thai disciplines. Let's begin with our feet shoulder-width apart. To draw both hands into a fist, make sure your thumb is on the outside. We're gonna protect either side of our cheekbones with our elbows tucked into our core. First, we're gonna go through the southpaw stance. With the southpaw stance, we're gonna go ahead and draw our left leg back. Make sure that your shoulder and hip is facing away from your opponent. Now, we're gonna reset and bring our feet shoulder width apart. Let's go ahead with the orthodox stance. The orthodox stance is with our right leg back. Draw our right leg away from our left, with the hip and shoulder facing away from our opponent, and then reset. Okay, so let's go ahead and play a game. When you say southpaw, you're going to transition into your southpaw stance, and then when I say orthodox, you're gonna transition into your orthodox stance. Orthodox. Orthodox. Southpaw. Orthodox. Southpaw, orthodox, orthodox, and time. All right, so now from both our stances, we're gonna practice our punches. Let's go ahead and start with the orthodox stance. So remember, we have that right leg back, hands are up, and we're gonna practice the jab cross punch. This is also known as the 1-2. The jab is gonna come from our lead hand. We're extending our fists out and driving the first two knuckles down. And we're gonna reset. And the cross is gonna come from the rear hand. So whatever hand is on the back side, that has to come across the chest. That's how the punch got its name, cross. Okay, so let's go ahead and put it together. We have jab, reset, cross, reset. Both punches are very similar. They're just straight. Difference is with the cross, I'm getting more momentum by taking the hip and shoulder and driving it through. Otherwise, if I punch it from back here, it's not enough reach. So I'm gonna get that reach through so I can land it on my opponent. Now try to follow my rhythm. Let's go. Punch, punch. Pick it up. Nice. Let's go faster. We got 4, 3, 2, 1, and nonstop. Let's go. With a non-stop, it's not necessary to constantly twist your back foot over. From here, you can just use your shoulder up top to reach through. We got 4, 3, 2, 1. Great job. Now we're back with our feet, both shoulder width apart. I'm gonna try everything from the southpaw stance. Go ahead and bring that left leg back. Both hands up either side of your cheekbone. And now, this time, our jab is with our right hand. So extending our right hand out, fist dropping down. This way I'm striking my opponent with the first two knuckles and then kicking reset. Now we have the cross with the left hand because this one's going across our chest. So as I drive this fist out, I'm gonna draw the first two knuckles down and then bring it back. Think of this punch like a boomerang. Everything is coming out and resetting back in. Look at my shoulder, transitioning forward and then back. Let's go ahead and put it together. We have jab and then cross. Naturally, very tempting to lean with that cross hand, But since our jab is right in front and we can land it faster, I'm just gonna blind our opponent with this punch first and then strike with the cross. Get that rhythm going. That's it. Try to follow after me. Keep it going. We got 4, 3, 2, 1, and non-stop. Let's go. Sit. Keep your elbows tucked in. I want those punches coming back to your face. Make sure you're not dropping your hands. If you're dropping your hands, that means your hands are coming too low. They should be coming back to your cheekbone. One hand punching, one hand protecting your face. Pick it up. We got 4, 3. Use those shoulders. 2, 1. Beautiful. And let's reset. We're going to bring our feet into the shoulder width position. So we have both feet apart. We're going to take our hands up and we're going to bounce side to side. Woo! We have that fight and bounce. 10 seconds. Both feet should be landing at the same time to either side. Keep those elbows tucked into your core. Hands up, chin down. Let's go. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Okay, now we're going to transition back into our orthodox stance. So let's go ahead and bring that right leg up. And the first thing we're going to do is work on a pullback. So this is one of my favorite defenses. With the pullback, you're going to take your back leg, step out, and then reset. Bring it back to where it started. So step out, and then reset. So this is a good way of getting out of the way of your opponent's strike. However, you're keeping your front leg where it's at, so you can stay in range. So by the time you reset, you can go ahead and land your punch. So instead of stepping completely out the way, and now you're out of range where you can't strike back, you're gonna stay in range, take that back leg, move out the way, and then counter. Okay, so let's pull back together. Ready? Pull, reset. Pull. 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 Keep it going. Even when you pull, you're staying on your toes to build your athleticism and to be explosive. You want to stand on balls of your feet. We got 4. Keep pulling. 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Let's work on a combination with that pull. We have jab, cross, pull back. Right after we reset, we're gonna throw that cross again. Jab, cross, pull, cross. Let's go. We're gonna do it slow a couple of times. This way you're building mind, muscle memory, getting used to the combination. Then when you feel like you got it down pat, we're gonna pick it up. Couple more times slow. Make sure you're turning that knuckle over. Strike it with the first two. 1, 2. Pull. 2. Let's go. 1, 2. Pull. 2. Sometimes repeating the combination to yourself out loud will also help you remember. Try it out. 1, 2. Pull. 2, and let's build that speed. Let's go. All right, we're gonna wait a bit. And when I say combo, you're gonna execute the combination. Combo. That's it. While you're waiting, with your hands up, you can bounce your shoulders side to side. Combo. 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 out. Oh yeah. If you need a little arm break, good, go ahead and shake out one hand at a time. Keep one hand up, protecting your face. Shake out one hand, circle it. Woo! Oh yeah. We got 3, 2, 1, and let's try it from the southpaw stance. Left leg back. And now what we're gonna do is work on that pull back. So I'm taking my back foot, I'm bringing it away from my target, and then resetting, ending at the same spot that I just started. So we have away from my back foot, and then resetting. Let's go. Don't worry about moving your head back. Since my body is moving away, my head is naturally coming with it. That's it. Keep going. Pull, reset. Pull, reset. Pull, reset. Every time I punch you, pull. Pull, reset. Pull, reset. Pull, reset. I'm gonna imagine an opponent striking at me, getting out the way. Stay in a ball of your feet. It's gonna be tempting to drop on your heel. Keep that heel up. We got 3, 2, 1, and put it together. Jab, cross, pull back, cross. Or I might say it with numbers. 1, 2, pull, 2. Same thing. Let's go. Start slow, working your form. 1, 2, pull, 2.
Rising to the occasion. Since you started this workout, that makes you a contender.
have that determination to challenge yourself today, and now we're going to rise above that challenge. Let's go together. Now we're going to take it back into the southpaw stance. Go ahead and bring your left leg back. We have both hands up, and we're going to work our hook punches. So we did the straight punches directly to our opponent's face. Now we're going to go around to the side of their cheekbones. Let's start with that lead hand. This one is also called the front hook, or three. So to execute that front hook, basically I'm lifting my elbow up and dropping the first two knuckles down. My fist, elbow, and shoulder are the same height. I need my shoulders the same height as my fist. This way, if I am hitting an actual target, it takes on that impact. With my elbow being up, it blocks an incoming punch. Other hand up, protecting the opposite side of your face. As I drive my elbow up, what I'm gonna do is twist my front leg into the punch. So my foot is following the direction of the punch. This way I have power behind that hook. So imagine your weight being that force behind the punch. To take your weight through, twist your foot, you're gonna stop on that imaginary target and then reset. It's a very short punch. It might not feel powerful just yet, but as you get used to the motion, your body will start understanding how to execute motion from this short movement. And it's all about returning quickly. Hook, return quick. You want to think of your punches as boomerangs. And that snap back is going to create that speed and power. Oh yeah. All right, now we have that rear hook. So for the rear hook, I want you to imagine your fist is a paintbrush. Now we're going to paint a half circle around. So we have the same concept with the elbow up and shoulder up, creating this lovely 90 degree angle. I'm going to take that back leg and twist it. You need that range of motion with the hip to drive my punch around. So even though I'm punching around to the side, I'm still looking forward, keeping my eye right on my target. My opponent is not around. I'm just hitting around to the side of them. Sneaking my punch into a different direction that they might not expect. We got 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go for nonstop. One punch at a time. So with each punch, I want you to practice pivoting with that same according foot into the direction of the punch. One hand up, one hand striking. Exhaling on each punch. We have 4, 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and reset. I'm gonna try the other side. So now, for my orthodox stance, I'm gonna try the front hook with the hand that's now in front, closer to my target, reset, and the rear hook, the one that has to travel the furthest. Okay, let's go. Around to the side, reset. Around to the side, reset. Keep going. If you feel like you got it, if you need a breakdown, you can stop with me. Lift up that elbow, like before. Notice as I lift it up, I'm bringing my fist outside and I'm twisting over. And I'm driving my weight towards the back leg. Oh yeah. Now try that other side and keep it going. The other side's gonna have more torque. It's traveling from a longer distance. The longer a punch travels, the more velocity it creates. So imagine that power coming from that rear hook. Oh yeah. We got 3, 2, 1, and nonstop on this side. Let's go. 10 seconds. Looking good. Five, four, three, two, bust it out. Oh yeah. Whew. Those bounces are looking good. So guys, I'm a fan of long combinations. If you remember the combination from earlier, we have the 1-2, pull back, 2. We're gonna add it on to a second set of combo. Okay, so first let's practice that second combination that we're gonna do. Get back into your stance. We're starting to southpaw. Hands are up. We're gonna try some ducks. So hooks, we're going around to the face. If your opponent was trying to throw a hook at you, the best defense option would be to duck underneath. I want you to imagine there's a rope next to you and go under that rope, drop down, try to draw you with your body and come up to the other side of that rope. I'm gonna go again, drop down, come up to the other side. Notice I'm switching directions with my shoulders every time I pop up from this roll. Yes, rolling down and up. We got 3, 2, 1, roll up, and let's throw a front hook. You're gonna roll back and throw a rear hook. Try it out, roll forward, front hook. Roll back hook. Go, roll, hook, that's it. So I'll tell you which direction to roll, you ready? Front. So every time you roll forward, throw that front hook. Front. Let's go back. On back, throw that back hook. Back. Front. Back. Front. That's it. You can bounce in between while you're waiting. So bounce the shoulders side to side. Back. Front. Really good. Back. All right. And let's put it together with that first combination. We have 1, 2. Pull back, 2, we're gonna roll back hook. Try it out, 1, 2, pull back, 2, roll back hook, let's go. Oh yeah. We got 3, 2, 1. Oh yeah. After that back hook, we're gonna roll forward and execute our front hook. Put it together. 1, 2, pull back, 2, roll back, rear hook, roll forward, front hook. Let's go. Feel free to mimic me. Jab, cross, pull, cross, roll, hook, looking good. Sit. As long as you keep your game face on, your opponent will never know you messed up. You can keep it between you and your arc. We have 3, 2, 1. All right, and bounce. Let's go side to side. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and let's go for straight ducks. Keep your feet shoulder width apart. I want to duck down for 10. On my count, duck. Orthodox and practice our ducks. We're gonna just drop down, create a U at the bottom, and come up to the other side. Hands to either side of your cheek. Let's go. Drop down, create a U, and to the other side. So we're ducking forward, switching our shoulder at the top, and ducking back. You don't have to duck too low, because it'll slow down your movement. Everything in boxing has to be quick. Remember, punches are coming at you quick, so you want to duck fast. Now, when we duck forward, we're going to execute that front hook, then reset. When we duck back, we're going to execute that back hook, and then reset. Let's go ahead and try it out. Duck forward, front hook. Duck back, rear hook. Feel free to take your time in between each. Duck, hook, reset. When the reset, you can take a small break. Keep those hands up on that break. As I'm resetting and taking my break, I like to imagine a punch is coming at me. Then I can go real time with my imagination. That's it. So take your time to create that visualization in your head of a strike coming right to the side of your cheek and going underneath and countering. Under, counter. You got 3, 2, 1. Let's add it with our combination. Okay, so we have jab, cross, and then from here, pull back, cross, duck back, hook. Let's go. 1, 2, pull, 2, duck, hook. Looking good, looking good. Hands up, keep your eyes on the prize. Let's go ahead and add that front roll with the front hook to finish our combination. Let's go, put it together. 1, 2, pull, 2, duck, hook, duck, hook. Oh yeah, and again. 1, 2, pull, 2, duck, hook, duck, hook. If you feel like this is way too advanced for you, or you're just not catching up, maybe take out the defense, like the duck and the pull, and just work on the punches. 1, 2, hook, hook. You can do that. 1, 2, hook, hook. You got 5 seconds. Exhale on each punch, Notice the angle I'm taking with my upper body as I throw this punch. Pushing my shoulders through. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, and nonstop. Let's go. Oh yeah, one hand up, one hand punching. So even though I'm going fast, notice when I pause, I have one hand on my cheek. So I'm still practicing my form as I'm speeding through. We have 3, 2, 1, and switch. Okay, so now we're gonna do the front uppercut on the other side. So again, we're bringing up this, drawing it away from my face, and also creating that down up motion with the body. So at the same time, you drop down, bring your fist away, and then come up, stop on that imaginary target, and reset. Let's go. Exhale as you do the strike. If you're intermediate or advanced, feel free to slip into that combination. Otherwise, just stay on top. Work those shoulders, get a little nice torque, and up into that punch. All right, now let's go for the opposite. Drive your fist away from your face, like so. Gonna add a little footwork with it, twisting a ball of my back foot, and then create that down up motion with my body. So this down up motion just prevents you from dropping your hand and leaving your face exposed. So rather than doing that, I'm just gonna get some momentum by locking my hip down and driving it up. It's a nice setup too, in case a strike is coming at you, getting out the way of a strike and encountering with one of your own. Out the way and counter. We got 3, 2, 1, and nonstop. Let's go. Pick up that speed. Pause. And back to it. Looking good. Pause. And back to it. One hand up, one hand striking. Woo! Keep going, guys. We have 3, 2, 1. Now, so we're gonna step forward. Add those two uppercuts right down in the middle. Step back, 1, 2. Let's go. Step forward, up, up. Step back, 1, 2. When you step forward, try to maintain that space in between your legs, like so. This is a good combination to practice with resistance bands. Come up, sneak those punches right in the middle. Step back, strike. Let's go. Get out the way, strike back. Right. Imagine you're going real time. Keep those hands up in between your movement. When you move, hands up. So sneaking those punches in, getting out, and countering. The faster you do this combination at home, the faster you're gonna be in the gym. Remember, whatever you input into training, you're gonna get out. We have 3, 2, 1, good job, and bounce it out. This time we're just gonna bounce right in our stance so you can stay southpaw. Keep those hands up, and we're gonna switch in 3, 2, 1, and switch. Let's go ahead, step forward, lead with that front leg when you're going forward. Step back, lead with the back leg when you're going back, and strike with that 1, 2. That's it. Get back. Keep it going. You guys are doing real good. Like what I'm seeing. Let's get those punches stronger. Tight fist. When your eyes are on the prize, show me your game face. Get out the way. Straight back. That's it. Hands up. Stay focused. Fast footwork. This is where we're explosive athletes. Staying the ball through your feet. And three, two, one, and shake it out. Woo! You guys did a real good job today. Go ahead and shake out those arms. Remember, one hand at a time. Feel free to round it up. We're gonna go for a burnout to finish. In three, two, one, let's go. Burnout, non-stop jab cross punches. Imagine you're hitting both imaginary targets, the C target with both fists. Every time I say duck, I want you to duck down and then go back to that 1-2. Ready and duck. Let's go, back to that 1-2. Pick it up. Duck. Duck. 7 seconds. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, duck, and one. Woo, good job, guys. Give yourselves a hand. Thank you guys for rocking it out with me today. I hope you enjoyed class. I know I did. Make sure you keep that 31 days of fitness going strong. My name is Raquel Harris, and I'll see you all soon.